Hello students, in this video session we will discuss about the phylum Coelenterata. Let us we start with this phylum. In previous video we discussed about the first phylum, that is Porifera, and now let we discuss about the phylum and its feature with examples. So that is Coelenterata. Coelenterata is also called Cnidaria. Cnidaria, the members belongs to this phylum are called Cnidarians or Coelenterates. So commonly called as Coelenterates or Cnidarians. What you called? Cnidarians, right? Or Coelenterates. Coelenterates, right? So the members or the examples belongs to this phylum are called Cnidarians or Coelenterates. So let us we take the first examples. See the Physalia. So that is a one of the example, Physalia. So it is a free swimming animal. So it is also called Portuguese man of war. Portuguese man of war. So it was a technique used by the Portuguese soldiers. So that's why this is named as Portuguese man of war, because sometimes which floats on the surface water and it is submerged immediately and it is escaping from the enemy. So that's why it is named as Portuguese man of war. And next one, the example is Adamsia. Adamsia is another example. Adamsia, Adamsia. So that is commonly called as sea anemone. Sea anemone is usually attached to the other animal's body, or sometimes usually which may be attached to the any thing which is there in the water, usually on the rock or other crabs also, right? So hard surface it will be attached, hence it is said to be sessile. What you call it? It's a sessile one. Next, and next one more example is Penetula. What you call it? Penetula. Penetula is named as a sea pen. We also referred it as a sea pen, right? Sea pen. And Gorgonia, one more Gorgonia, that is called sea pan. Sea pan. And one more example here, Mendriana. What you call Mendriana? So that is brain coral. There are a group of corals. So even brain coral, cup coral, like different types of corals are there. So which have specialized features. So let us we take it later. Okay, features we will discuss. Right. Next, Hydra is one of the primitive, what you called animal belongs to this Coelenterata. Very primitive animal, so we can say. And Aurelia, Aurelia is also called jellyfish. More commonly called as a jellyfish. Right. So body is like a gel. So hence we call it as jellyfish, but it is not belongs to the fish. Right. So it is a Coelenterata. This is the second phylum of invertebrate. You remember invertebrates. These are right. So let us we discuss now the silent features or the general characters of this what you called phylum, right? First let we take general characters. General characters or features, right? Features. First one. So here the members belongs to this phylum are aquatic. Mostly they are aquatic. All are aquatic, usually marine. They are exclusively aquatic, we can say exclusively aquatic, but there are some are usually marine. Called marine, mostly marine, right? Marine means ocean water or sea water or saline water. In such water bodies they are surviving. Okay, they are adapted to the this kind of water, right? So hence we can say that they are marine forms, right? So here let we say that is sometimes they are freely swimming in the water. They are some are freely swimming, and some are sessile. What is the meaning here? Freely swimming means usually there are two forms, we can say. They are showing the alternate generation, okay, the distinct alternate generation. So there are two forms of body we can say. One is polyp, one is polyp, another one is medusa. So actually these are the two forms of the body. In all animals we can observe that polyp. So as you might have observed the jellyfish, so a more common example, jellyfish is in the form of medusa. It's in the form of medusa. See, these are the two forms of the body which are produced each other, like what you called the polyp is produced. Let us talk this later about in the reproduction. Okay, so we'll understand this. Okay, first you remember the aquatic, these are aquatic animals, right? They are mostly marine and free swimming. Means for example, you can take the orally as free swimming, and sessile one is a sea anemone. You can take sea anemone is sessile because which is attached, its body is cylindrical and attached to the any substratums, right? So they are referred as sessile. Free swimming means with the help of tentacles usually they are swimming. Okay, even these are also sometimes used to swim, right? Because they have also tentacles, right? The body shows the tentacles, right? And the second one is the body is radially symmetrical. Radial, they shows the radial symmetry. Radial symmetry, they shows the radial symmetry. The line which is passing through any plane, so that is in any animal, so that shows that radial symmetry, because they give the two equal halls, right? So that is called radial symmetry, right? So and they are diploblastic. They are diploblastic. These are diploblastic animals, right? Diploblastic means there are two germ layers are there. They are referred as diploblastic, and there is a presence of central gastrovascular cavity. Yes, the fourth what I am taking here, they shows they have central gastrovascular cavity. It's not said to be a body cavity, it's a gastrovascular cavity. We can call it as gastrovascular cavity. Means for example, when sectional view observed that animals, these are showing this structure, right? Later we will discuss about the polyp and medusa here. Yes, so this is what the hydra structure, right, which is may be attached here somewhere, and this is what the tentacles is the single opening is there. So this throughout the opening there is a presence of what you call tentacles, right? So these are the tentacle structures what I have shown here, tentacles, right? So this cavity is called gastrovascular cavity, and these are the tentacles, right? These are tentacles. There is a this is what we call it as hypostoma, right? Stoma, and the central, this gastrovascular cavity centrally, which is situated, so hence we call it as central gastrovascular cavity, and it is opened with a single opening is there, that is called mouth, or we can refer it as hypostoma. Mouth at upper side, so that is hypostoma, or right, it is also called mouth, right? So single opening is present here, you remember, right? Remaining let us discuss now. Yes, students, here the cylindrates are showing other special features in tentacles. So for example, when you take the structure of hydra or Aurelia, anyone, so these are the tentacles, right? So you can consider it as a tentacles which are surrounded around the mouth. This way you can see, these are the tentacles here, mouth will be there, right? So tentacles are having the specialized structures called, yes, these structures are called of course here also tissue level of organization we observe. So next point, fifth, you can refer it as a tissue level of organization. Tissue level of organization, simple tissue are formed here, and the mouth is surrounded by structures called tentacles. What do you call tentacles, right? So these tentacles and the body also, this what you call the body is there, no? So this body, tentacles as well as the body surface, body, on both these there are special structures or the cells we called, they are called needoblast. What you call needoblasts are also referred as needocytes. Needocytes. This needocytes are consisting, which are consisting a specialized capsule like structure that is called stinging cells. These are also called stinging cells. What you call stinging cells, because they have a sting. They have sting like structure is there. So this sting, due to presence of this sting, they are considered as stinging cells. They are like a capsule like structures inside the needoblast, right? Needoblast, okay. So that sting is a help for different functions, mainly for defense. The stinging cells are helps in defense and anchorage, we can say anchorage, to hold the any other animal surfaces. So it will be utilized, and defense means they can escape from the enemies by pricking with the help of this sting. Okay, very minute and stings are there thrown usually, and capture the prey, and even you use it for capturing the prey, food. Prey means here food. So there are many, these are the functions of stinging cells, right? So stinging capsule, we are also referred as a stinging capsule, because it may, so there is a, like it appears like a flagella, but it is not referred as a flagella like structure, okay. So in this way we can draw the diagram. Here inside there is capsule like structure is there, even it is able to take it inside. Okay, sometimes it may be taken it inside, right? And it is able to, this sting is came outside when it is required for the, these functions, right? The functions of sting is defense. Defense means that can escape from the other enemies, right? So, and next, anchorage, like holding, okay? So, and next, capturing the prey. These are the functions of this stinging cell, okay. This is what we call a needoblast, structure of needoblast, which are present in the, yes, tentacles and on the body also, right, body. So of course these are diploblastic animals. So centrally there is a what we called a cavity is there, so that is called a gastrovascular cavity, as I explained. And next one, the tissue level of organization, as I explained here. And the sixth point, you can take the digestion. Sixth one, you can take digestion is both extracellular and intracellular. Both type of digestion is takes place. Extracellular means outside the cell, means it is in the gastrovascular cavity, and inside the cell if it is takes place, that is called intracellular digestion. Digestion is also simple here, so that is the extracellular and intracellular, right? Next, the corals, what I have given the examples, corals, see here, the corals, the seventh point you can add. Corals are showing endoskeleton, corals with skeleton system, skeleton. So this is made up of pure calcium carbonate, CaCO3. Calcium carbonate is forms the this what you called the endoskeleton, the skeleton of the corals, right? Corals are different types of corals, what I brain corals, which is appears like a brain, and cup coral we can say, which is appears like a small cup. And even there is a corals are there in the ocean, which forms the big what you called Iceland. Okay, so like it appears, so Great Barrier Reef of corals you might have heard, okay, nearby Australia, the Great Barrier Reef of corals we can say, right? So next, they exhibit two forms, let us we discuss those. The next 8 point take. These cnidarians have two forms, let us we see two forms of this one, polyp and medusa. They exhibit 8 point I am writing. They exhibit in two forms, that is they are two forms are polyp and medusa. Polyp and medusa, let us we try to understand what is polyp and medusa. See here, polyp and medusa are nothing but these are two alternative generations. Polyp can able to produce medusa and medusa again it can able to produce the polyp. So already I gave polyp means that is usually as sessile, so we call it as the sessile one and cylindrical structure. Polyp is a sessile. Sessile means which is usually attached, which is not free swimming, okay, which is attached to the other things in the ocean or the that water body, okay, that is called sessile. And medusa is free living, free swimming, right? Free swimming we can say. That's a referred as a free swimming, right? Freely which is swimming in the water body, right? So it is a sessile and it is a free swimming, and it appears like a cylindrical, and it is like a umbrella jellyfish. We can give the example of Aurelia, or we also call it as jellyfish, right? And cylindrical Obelia you can give, Obelia or sea anemone, we can also give the sea anemone. So both can be observed here in the Obelia, okay. One of the example we can observe that like it's appears like a plant, but not it is like plant, it is an animal, right? So that is the polyp and also medusa are nearly we can observe in the Obelia, but the structure which is attached to the substratum is called sessile one, and which is freely swimming, so that is called free swimming, that is called medusa, right? So these are the two forms of body, hence there is a alternation of generation, what you call the that is called alternation of generation. This phenomenon is called alternation of generation. So this alternation of generation are these are the two generations which we observed, two generation, that is polyp and medusa, right? So here polyp is a cylindrical and it can able to produce the medusa by a sexual method, by asexually. Means next point you can write reproduction. Reproduction is both by asexual and sexual. Asexually it can produce the polyp, can produce the medusa, okay. They are like some structures which are released from the polyp structure. There are many medusa released and they are starts freely swimming in the water, and again they are producing the by sexual method. Sexually medusa can produce the polyp, right? So again polyp are formed. In this way there are two forms of the body we observed in this that nid area, right? That is called alternation of generation. It's also termed as metagenesis. What you call metagenesis? Metagenesis, right? So this is what about the polyp and medusa, you remember? So this is one of the important feature of this phylum, right? So and these are the two forms of nidaria or coelenterata, you remember? And stinging cells, presence of stinging cells is a special feature of these organisms, special features, right? There are unique features and identification features, we can say. There is a presence of tentacles with stinging cells, okay? They are also referred as what you call stinging capsules, okay? Stinging cells, presence of that is important here. And there are two forms also we observed, okay? These are the points to be remembered regarding the phylum Coelenterata, right? So with examples and these few characters you should remember, okay? So please note the characters also, okay? Thank you, students.